السلام عليكم. Today I am going to talk about second chapter of HCIA DataCom version 1 training certification network reference model. In the digital era, various information is presented as data in our life. What is the data? How is data transmitted? In this module, we will use the network reference model to understand the life of data. On completion of this course, you will be able to understand the data definition and the transmission process, understand the concepts and advantages of network reference model, understand common standard protocols, understand the data encapsulation and decapsulation process. First section, applications and data. Origin of the story, applications. Applications are used to meet various requirements of people such as web page access, online gaming and online video playback. Information is generated along with applications, text, pictures and videos are all information presentation modes. Applications such as Google Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer, Microsoft Edge. Information such as texts, pictures, and videos, all information presentation modes. Application implementation data. Data generation. In the computer field, data is the carrier of all kind of information. Data transmission, data generated by most applications, needs to be transmitted between devices. A computer can identify only digital data consisting of zeros and ones. It's incapable of reading other types of information, so the information needs to be translated into data by certain rules. However, people don't have the capability of reading electronic data. Therefore, data needs to be converted into information that can be understood by information by people. A network engineer needs to pay more attention to the end-to-end data transmission process. You can see this computer as a source can send data to the destination server through the network. Second section, network reference model and the standard protocol. OSI reference model, you can see we have 7 layers: physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, application layer. The Open Systems Interconnection Model OSI was included in the ISO standard and released as a standard to data communication. The OSI reference model have 7 layers. Application layer provides interfaces for applications such as Google Chrome, Firefox, any other applications. Presentation layer translates data formats to ensure that application layer data of one system can be identified by application layer of another system, such as encryption and compression. Session layer establishes, manages, and terminates sessions between communicating parties. Transport layer establishes, maintains, and cancels an end-to-end data transmission process. Control transmission speeds and adjusts data sequences. Network layer defines logical addresses and transfers data from sources to destinations. Data link layer encapsulates packets into frames, transmits frames in point-to-point or point-to-multipoint mode and implements error checking. Physical layer transmits bit streams over transmission media and defines electrical and physical specifications. We can aggregate our OSI reference model to TCP over IP reference model. The OSI protocol stack is complex. You can see that OSI reference model have 7 layers, and the TCP and IP protocols are widely used in the industry. Therefore, the TCP over IP reference model becomes the mainstream reference model of the internet. A standard of TCP over IP model, network access layer as a layer 1, internet layer, you can see network access layer generated from physical layer and data link layer, internet layer opposite to network layer, host to host layer opposite to transport layer, and application layer, presentation layer, session layer aggregated to application layer on standard of TCP over IP stack model. Equivalent TCP over IP stack model, you can see physical layer as a bottom layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, and application layer. Common TCP over IP protocols. The TCP over IP protocol stack defines a series of standard protocols. Application layer have many applications, such as and services such as Telnet service for remote access and FTP file transfer protocol and HTTP services and Simple Mail Transfer Protocol Service and TFTP, Trivial File Transfer Protocol, DNS, Domain Name System, Simple Network Management Protocol, and Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. All of these services are applications. Transport layer, you can see we have two protocols, TCP and UDP. TCP stand for Transmission Control Protocol, and UDP stand for User Datagram Protocol. Network layer, ICMP protocol, Internet Control Message Protocol, and IGMP for Multicast Services, Internet Group Management Protocol, and IP Internet Protocol. Data link layer, protocols such as BBBOE, point-to-point over Ethernet, and Ethernet protocol, BBB point-to-point protocol. Ethernet protocol for LAN technology and point-to-point protocol, and BBBOE for WAN technology, wide area network. And physical layer bit streams. Common protocol standardization organizations. Internet Engineering Task Force, IETF. IETF is an organization responsible for developing and promoting internet protocols, especially protocols that constitute the TCP over IP protocol suite, and releasing new or replacing old protocol standards through RFCS. Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, IEEE. IEEE has formulated about 30% of standards in the electronics, electrical, and computer science fields worldwide. Those standards include well-known IEEE 802.3 for Ethernet standard, and IEEE 802.11 Wi-Fi standard. Third organization, International Organization for Standardization, ISO organization. ISO is an international organization that plays an important role in the formulation of computer network standards such as OSI defined model. We will talk about this reference model. First layer we will talk about is the top layer application layer. The application layer provides interfaces for application software so that applications can use network services. The application layer protocol designed for transport layer protocols and ports. BDUs transmitted at the application layer are called data. BDU of the application layer, you can see that called data. Examples of protocols in application layer. First, protocol HTTP, a TCP protocol that use TCP services. Port number 80. Hypertext transfer protocol which provides web browsing services. Another protocol, Telnet. 23 TCP service used for remote login or remote access which provides remote management services. FTP file transfer protocol, ports numbers 20 and 21 use TCP services. File transfer protocol which provides internet file resource sharing services. SMTP simple mail transfer protocol 25 use services TCP transmission control protocol. Simple mail transfer protocol which provides internet email services. TFTP trivial file transfer protocol 69 UDP service. Simple file transfer protocol which provides simple file transfer services. Common application protocol FTP. The file transfer protocol FTP transfers the file from one host to another to implement the file download and upload. This protocol adopts the client server structure. You can see in this topology we have FTP client and FTP server. FTP client provides the commands for local users to operate files on the remote server. A user can install an FTP client program on a PC and set up connection with an FTP server to operate files on the server. FTP server, a device that runs the FTP service. It provides the access and operation functions for remote clients, allowing users to access the FTP server through the FTP client program and access files on the server. Common application layer protocols, another protocol or second protocol, Telnet. Telnet is a standard protocol that provides remote login services on network. It provides users with the ability to operate remote devices through local PCs. You can see Telnet client and Telnet servers consists of many devices such as access point, router, switch, firewall, and server. Through Telnet connection, a user connects to Telnet server through the Telnet client program. The commands entered on the Telnet client are executed on the server as if the commands were entered on the console of the server. Third protocol, HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, is one of the most widely used network protocols on the internet. HTTP was originally designed to provide a method for publishing and receiving HTML pages. On this topology, you can see HTTP client and HTTP server. We want to access website www.huawei.com. When try to access www.wawi.com. Server returns the HTML file on the page that can you see on your browser. Transport layer. Transport layer protocol receives the data from an application layer protocol, encapsulates the data with the corresponding transport layer protocol header, and helps establish an end-to-end or host-to-host or port-to-port connection. PDUs transmitted at the transport layer are called segments. Transport layer or segments as a PDU. Transport layer protocols, common protocols TCP, a connection-oriented reliable protocol. UDP, a simple connectionless protocol defined by IETF. TCP and UDP header formats. You can see header formats on this figure. You can see source port and destination port, sequence number, acknowledgement number, and header length. Reserved control bits window as a main flags on the TCP header. TCP header 20 bytes and UDP header 8 bytes. You can see format of UDP header, source port, destination port, length, checksum, and data as a payload. TCP and UDP port numbers. On this topology, you can see HTTP client house number 1.1.1.1 IP address and destination IP address of HTTP server 2.2.2.2 IP address. HTTP client open web browser and telnet services. When opening web browser, you can use HTTP application through port or source port 1024, and another application telnet use source port 1231 as a port, and you can see format of your packet through source IP address 1.1.1.1, destination IP address 2.2.2.2, and TCP header source port number 1024, destination port number 80. You can see destination port number as HTTP service and HTTP payload. When your packet transmitted to HTTP server and HTTP server received, you can see delivered through TCP port 80 port and delivered to HTTP server. You can trace telnet services through this packet. Your packet when access telnet service on the server, source IP 1.1.1.1, destination IP 2.2.2.2, source port number 1231, destination port number 23, and telnet payload. Generally, the source port used by client is randomly allocated, and the destination port is specified by application of a server. The system generally selects a source port number that is greater than 1023 and is not being used for public services. The destination port number is listening port. It's the listening port of the application service enabled on the server. For example, the default port number of HTTP is 80. TCP connection setup, three-way handshake. Before sending a data, TCP-based application needs to establish a connection through three-way and a check. Your PC, before sending data to the destination when using TCP service, the PC must establish a connection through your message three-way hand check. Three-way hand check on PC1 and PC2, IP header source IP 1.1.1.1, destination IP 2.2.2.2, TCP header as random sequence A, acknowledge 0, flags, first flag is synchronization flag. When PC2 receives this message, PC2 can reply. Can reply through sequence B and acknowledge A plus 1. You can see that acknowledge A plus 1, you must receive sequence A from PC1 and request A plus 1 through acknowledgement flag. And PC1 send sequence A plus 1 as your request. Your request, you want BC1 to send A plus 1. BC1 send A plus 1 through sequence flag and acknowledge B plus 1. Acknowledge B plus 1 means that BC1 need B plus 1. As he received, it received B, and therefore TCP connection is established. This is a three-way handshake method. TCP sequence number and acknowledgement number. TCP uses the sequence number and acknowledgement number fields to implement reliable and ordered data transmission. You can see BC1 and BC2. After three-way handshake and TCP connection is established, BC1 started to send segments or data to BC2 through first message source 1.1.1.1, destination 2.2.2.2, first sequence A plus 1. A plus 1 when BC2 received A plus 1, it requests A plus 1 or second segment or second sequence. A plus 1 plus 12. You can see in on BC1 sequence, your sequence equal A plus 13, and your data transmitted to BC2. After BC2 received it request A plus 12 plus 66. TCP window sliding mechanism. TCP uses the sliding window mechanism to control the data transmission rate. After three-way handshake, on three-way handshake, sequence, you can determine window number of sequence transmitted through the connection, window equal 3. First, BC can send your 3 sequence 101, 102, 103. When BC2 receives this sequence, acknowledge 104, and BC1 can start to send 104, 105, 106. You can negotiate on your window size through transmission. It depends on your connection status. TCP shutdown four-way handshake. After your connection, you can terminate your connection through four-way handshake. After data termination is complete, TCP needs to use the four-way handshake mechanism to disconnect the TCP connection release system resources. TCP connection is established. TCP segments exchange. Finally, BC can terminate the connection throughway message finish. I want to finish my connection with BC2. BC2 send acknowledgement and message to finish the connection, and BC1 acknowledge this termination. After that process, the TCP connection is shut down. On this slide, we will talk about network layer. The transport layer is responsible for establishing connections between processes on hosts, and network layer is responsible for transmitting data from one host to another. BDUs transmitted at the network layer are called packets. You can see BDU on application layer is data, transport layer segments, network layer packets. The network layer is also called the internet layer as TCP over IP stack model. It sends packets from source hosts to destination hosts. Functions of network layer provides logical addresses for network devices, routes and forwards data packets. Common network layer protocols include IP version 4 and IP version 6, ICMP and IGMP, as we mentioned in previously on slides. Working process of a network layer protocol. Packet encapsulation. You can see you have letter data sent by upper layer, for example, the transport layer, envelope IP, packet header, sender, source IP address, receiver, destination IP address. Envelope mean IP packet header. Sender means source IP address, receiver means that destination IP address. On this topology, BC1 wants to send data to BC2 on the network A. BC encapsulates IP header envelope. The key information is about source and destination IP addresses. And this your message destinated to router 1. And router 1 inspect routing table and found that network A through interface giga 001 and send the data to another router, and router inspect data find that destination through next hop this router, and this router inspect send your data to BC2 on network A. The network layer header of a packet sent by source device carries the network layer addresses of the source and destination devices. Each network device, such as a router that has the routing function, maintains a routing table like map of the network device. After receiving a packet, the network device reads the network layer destination address of a packet, search the routing table for matching entry of the destination address, and forwards the packet according to the instruction of matching entry. Data link layer. The data link layer is located between network layer and physical layer and provides services for protocols such as IP and IP version 4 and IP version 6 at the network layer. Videos transmitted at the data link layer are called frames. Ethernet is the most common data link layer protocol. The data link layer is located between network layer and physical layer. You can see that located between physical and network. The data link layer provides intra-segment communication for network layer inside local area network. The functions of data link layer include framing, physical addressing, and error control through FCS, frame check sum. Common data link layer protocols include Ethernet and triple PoE, triple B. Ethernet and source MAC addresses. Ethernet definition: Ethernet is a broadcast multiple access protocol that works at the data link layer protocol. The network interfaces of PC comply with Ethernet standard. Generally, a broadcast domain corresponds to an IP network segment. You can see this topology have one broadcast domain. One broadcast domain that BC1 or host A send a broadcast to all PCs on this network. Ethernet source MAC address. MAC address is a unique identifier of your PC inside network, local area network. A media access control unique identifies a NIC on a network. Each NIC requires and has a unique MAC address. MAC addresses are used to locate a specific physical device in an IP network segment. A device that works at data link, such as Ethernet switch, maintains a MAC address table to guide data frame forward. MAC address, unique identifier. You can see name host A, MAC address, Ethernet address, or physical address. All of these mean MAC address. ARP. ARP stands for Address Resolution Protocol. Discovers the MAC address associated with a given IP address. When host A wants to connect with host B, for first time, host A sends ARP request. ARP request to request the MAC address of the destination IP for first time, and host B send ARP reply that mean host A and host B MAC address. Host A want to know MAC address of host B for first time. Host A send ARP request to host B, and host B replied with the MAC with its MAC address, and host A for second time can save this MAC address on ARP cache table. ARP implementation principles. Host A checks cache ARP entry. Host A send ARP request. For first time, it check cached ARP entry. No MAC address in ARP cache. Before sending a datagram, a device search its ARP table for destination MAC address of the datagram. If the destination MAC address exists in the ARP table, the device encapsulates the MAC address in the frame and seconds out the frame. If the destination MAC address doesn't exist in the ARP table, the device sends an ARP request to discover the MAC address of the host. ARP cache table is empty. Second, host A sends ARP request. ARP request, operation type, ARP request, destination MAC address zeros to discover a MAC address of host 2. Host 1 send ARP request to discover the MAC address of host 2. The destination MAC address in the ARP request is zeros because the destination MAC address is unknown. For the first time, host A didn't know host 2 MAC address. سير host 2 add an arg entry. You can see arg-a command. This is IP address mapped to physical address of host 1. After receiving the arg request message, is each host it checks whether it's the destination of message based on carried destination IP address. Host 2 finds that it's the destination of the message and then records the mapping between sender's MAC and IP addresses in its ARG table. Host 2 send an ARG reply. Host 2 send ARG reply to host 1. In this step, host 2 has discovered the MAC address of host 1, so the ARG reply is a unicast data frame. After receiving a unicast data frame, the switch forwards the frame. When it check host 1 ARG table through ARG-A, you can see host 2 MAC address table inserted in ARG cache. Physical layer, bottom layer of OSI reference model. After data arrives at the physical layer, the physical layer converts digital signal into an optical signal, an electrical signal or electromagnetic wave signals based on the physical media. VDUs transmitted at physical layer are called bit streams. The physical layer is at bottom of the model. This layer transmits bit streams or media. Physical features such as cable, pins, voltages, and interfaces. Common transmission media include twisted pair, optical fibers, and electromagnetic waves. Common transmission media, you can see twisted pair, cable, data transmission through twisted pair. You can see data transmission through optical fiber, fiber module, optical module. You can see transmission through serial cables, synchronous, asynchronous, serial cables. Transmission between terminals, wireless routers, through wireless signals. Data communication process. Data encapsulation on sender. When you want to access www.huawei.com, this is data encapsulates with a TCP header on the transport layer and converted to segments as a TCP header. You can see this data and TCP header encapsulates on network layer through IP header and data called packet. On network layer, the data payload and IP header encapsulated on the data link layer through Ethernet header and FCS frame check sum. And finally, data transmitted over transmission media as bit streams. Data transmission on intermediate network. Encapsulated data is transmitted on the network over network devices, your switch and routers. Finally, received at destination host. When data received on the destination host, data decapsulation on the receiver. Your data transferred through transmission media and host, your destination host, received your data through physical layer. And after received on physical layer, you can see decapsulate Ethernet header and FCS on the data link layer and decapsulate packet through IP address on packet on network layer and decapsulate your data through TCP header on transport layer. Finally, your data opened on your interface on application of the web server. Summary of this module or this chapter. both the OSI reference model and the TCP over IP reference model adopt the learned design concept. Clear division of functions and boundaries between layers facilitates the development, design, and the troubleshooting of each component. The functions of each layer can be defined to combine industry standardization. Interfaces can be provided to enable communication between hardware and software on various networks, improving capability. Data generation and the transmission require collaboration between modules. Meanwhile, each module must be fulfill its own responsibilities. Quiz. What are the benefits of layered model? You can see in previous slide the benefits of layered model facilitate troubleshooting and divide your network to layers and easy to understand data communication. What are common protocols at application layer, transport layer, network layer, and data link layer? On application layer such as HTTP, Telnet, on transport layer TCP and UDP, network layer IP and ICMP, data link layer TPP, TPPoE, and Ethernet protocol. Finally,